Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to the third chapter, Diversity in Living Things and Their Classification. In our last part, we have learnt about diversity in plants. In this part, we are going to learn about diversity in animals. Diversity in animals. Different animals have developed different shapes to survive in the environment. There is a great variety in the body structure, food, habitats. Animals have body parts like a head, a neck, a tail, a toes, and lips for movement. They have various organ systems which carry on various functions inside their body. Different animals have different methods of obtaining and eating food. What are the differences in the body structure of animals like a snake, lizard, tiger, fish, an eagle, a hen, a crab, a housefly, an earthworm, a crocodile, and a grasshopper? All these animals are classified in different categories. So today we are going to learn about classifications. Let's see classification according to the number of cells. Multicellular organisms. Multicellular organisms are made of two or more cells. These organisms are able to see with naked eyes. These organisms need all parts of itself to survive. Here are the examples: humans, animals, plants. Unicellular organisms. An organism made of one cell. These organisms are very small and need to be seen with a microscope. That means you cannot see them with your naked eyes. Here are the some examples of unicellular organisms: Paramecium, amoeba, bacteria, yeast. Classification according to the vertebral column. That means the animals which are having backbone. Vertebrate animals are animals with the backbone or vertebral column. There are five groups of vertebrate animals: mammals, birds, reptiles, amphibians, and fish. Invertebrate animals do not have a skeleton. Some examples of these are spiders, flies, and caterpillars. Vertebrates are often larger and have some complex bodies than invertebrate. However, there are many more invertebrate than vertebrates. Classification according to the mode of reproduction. Viviparous animals are born live. They give birth to the young ones like them. They depend on their mothers when they are babies. They drink their mother's milk. Example: dogs, cats, lions, horses, cows, etc. Oviparous animals are born from eggs. The female animals lay the eggs. Some oviparous animals like birds keep their eggs warm. Animals based on place they live. Based on where animals live, they are grouped. Terrestrial animals live on land. Aquatic animals live in water. Amphibians live on both on land and in water. Let's see in detail. Terrestrial animals. Animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. These animals have features suitable for life on land. They have legs which help them to walk on land, and most of them have lungs as their breathing organ. Aquatic aquatic animals. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. Most aquatic animals breathe through their gills, except whales and dolphins, which breathe through lungs. Most aquatic animals have fins or paddles that help them to swim. Here are some examples: fish, octopus, turtle, and crab. Amphibians, animals that live both on land and in water. The back legs of a frog and toad are stronger than their front legs. This helps them to jump, which is however they move on land. They have webbed feet that helps them to swim in water. Example, toad, frog. Aerial animals, animals that can fly and spend a lot on their time in the air are called aerial animals. Their hollow bones make their bodies light. They have one side set of lips modified as wings to help them fly. The body shape of aerial animals is such that they are able to cut through the air easily. In the cold winter months, when the food becomes scarce, many birds fly towards warmer countries in search of food and warmth. This mass movement of birds from a colder to a warmer place is called migration. Example, almost all birds except flightless birds and bats. What we have learned? Plants are classified on the basis of their height and the shape of stem, period of life cycle, and habitat. Animals are classified on the basis of the cell structure, vertebral column, method of reproduction, and habitat. Always remember, in the living world, a lot of diversity is seen both in animals and plants. Every plant and animal is unique. We should all make efforts to conserve this diversity in the living world.